my last Mana Decentraland flash analysis video, I was essentially trying to warn everybody that this asset is getting ready to correct. It's going to be a fairly deep correction, and it's going to take about 60 days. In this video, please, like, let me explain this to you in a different way. Help me help you. Let me have one more try to show you this. All right, let's dive in. I want you to focus your eyes on these lines. So just imagine, if price hit those lines, that looks pretty reasonable. Even the most bullish people can say, yeah, insanely bullish high or low. So that is super bullish. And so let's say, okay, that looks reasonable. Now we can ask ourselves, has it moved like this before? A copy paste price from here to here. That doesn't look like that bad of a down move, right? It's just a look. Let's copy and paste from that point to this point. It hits that yellow line. And per my analysis yesterday, I specifically said the RSI does have baked into the charts, even with this correction, one more baby pop, potentially up to $7. What is this? $6.30 in all aspects. It's moved like this before. It's massively mega bullish, high or low. Zoomed out on the charts, it's not that big of a move. Let me give you two more things that you need to see before I give you the bad news. And you're not going to like the freaking answers. You can't hit like if you don't flip your phones vertically. So flip your phones or get flipped off. And you know what's going to help me out even more? If you leave me a quick comment, a simple period without the tampon, yell something completely random such as yesterday and these consensuses, I'm a dickhead. Subscribe and hit this bell because this is time sensitive information. Help me help you. I follow me on Twitter at Cosas Verdes, number two. At Cosas Verdes, the number two. Giggity giggity. Let's jump back into the charts. Before I get to the bad news, throw on one single line. 12 hour 200 EMA. When in doubt, zoom out. That is a rule that you should live by. Got the moves pretty well. So below it, generally bad. Once you can get above it, use it as support, generally good. Essentially the master line of this asset, right? Lo and behold, what is going to be touching that yellow line and losing a little bit of its slope exactly as it approaches the yellow line? The same orange line. No matter how high it goes, it always comes back down to touch it. Lines perfectly with this yellow line, because as it approaches and price is going down, it will start losing its slope. So it's essentially going to come up to this yellow line and ride this origin line, and price is going to hit it. It's hit it 100% of times forever and always. The time is probably now. Look at this, 700%. It's going to come back to that line. I don't know how else to say this. And the second thing I wanted to show you is this before we get to the bad news. I'm gonna get to the bad news soon. The saving grace of this might be one single line, the 4 hour 200 EMA. So sometimes when things are mega bullish, what they'll do is they'll go way above the orange line. Price will scoop below it as the 4 hour 200 EMA goes like this, loses its slope, goes negative for a tiny bit. And that's exactly when price comes right back up. That might be the case where it doesn't get a deep correction down to the yellow line. That's almost exactly what price will look like. But still, that means it's still going to get down to this point. Price is going to hit this origin line here, 80, 90% likelihood. Okay, so now let's dive into the things you're not going to like. First off is the percentage move down. So let's say from current price, it doesn't wick up to $7, even though I think it actually has a good chance of wicking up to $7 first. 37% of that pink line. Okay, so from current price down to the yellow line is 50%. 700% run, that's way too aggressive and hits the master origin line. It likes to correct 60%. So what would this green line be? 60%. It's a rule of thumb for a reason, because it's statistically probable to happen. And not just 51% probable, but way higher than 50%. Help me help you. Like, yes, it might not happen. More insane shit has happened before. But I'm telling you, this is statistically probable to happen. That's the first thing you're not gonna like. Here's the second thing you're not gonna like, the time frame. So let's say it bumps up to $7, okay? And hits it in the middle of this line. That is February. This is the middle of February. So down and sideways for like 80, 90 days is what you're looking at. So it is a big down move. It's a long consolidation and it's probably gonna happen. I know you don't like it, but I'm trying to freaking help you. If you want to catch my last Decentraland Mana analysis, go ahead and click this link here. And if you want to learn how to set up a chart just like me, go ahead and click this link here. And if you were too damn lazy to flip your phones earlier and you couldn't hit like even or to dislike me, whatever, go ahead and hit the circle that's right here. And we'll see you later. You just got Simified.